Welcome back, new tubers. This is the new game here. We're once again playing Star Wars Squadrons. Yes, I remember the name this time. And I just like doing a little intro and continue the story. Because I know what happened the last time I click continue the story without starting a recording. You know what I found funny? You know what I find funny? The galaxy is a huge ass place. Hold on a second, let me turn my headset down. The galaxy is a huge ass place. And yet they actually managed to find it. There's got to be dozens of places you can put one of these. I mean, Project Stormhawk? Stormhawk. I was thinking Storehawk. Isn't there a missing cannon on the top? Oh, you know how in the, was it the last episode or the episode before that? How I was talking about how the, how certain starfighters and legends were created in response to other, into the, in the deficiencies of other fighters? Like how the A-Wing evolved, or the A-Wing was created as a response to the, was it the Death Star run? Well, the A-Wing was evolved from a different fighter. It looked looked almost exactly the same, but it evolved from it, and I think it was created as a response to the, yeah, to the Death Star run and something. Actually, I can't remember. I know the B-Wing was created in response to the Y-Wing's deficiencies. What the hell is that? Something on my phone screen. Yes, I've opened up my phone. I'm actually waiting an email from Halo Waypoint. So yeah. I do like the, I sometimes the notifications I get I like on my phone. Other ones I don't give two shits about. And what were we looking for? Oh. Wikipedia. Yes, Wikipedia. I remember they played an April Fool's joke on people a few years ago. They actually had me, sent me into a fucking panic. Like a straight up panic. Is how they were monetizing Wikipedia. Yeah. It took me a while to realize, and by a while I mean like 2 or 3 days. I should have realized what day it was. It was in fact an April Fool's joke, but I didn't realize the day. But it took me a while. I had actually limited my time because they were doing the prank was part of a timed thing free. You get a certain amount of time free. And A-Wing. But yeah, you get a certain amount of time free and then you have to pay for a membership. To be honest, I was a fool and yeah. That is this a Legends one? Oh yeah, the R-22 Spearhead, that's what it was evolved from. But is this the canon one? You know what? I got my computer up. It shouldn't matter. And while I'm searching for this, we can listen to Fisk. See what the hell he wants.
Hey, there you are. Was looking for you back at the dockyards. Instead, I had to hang out with a bunch of engineers. They told me a whole convoy of new engineers got intercepted by the Empire. No survivors. Sounds like they had someone on the inside at Hosnian Prime. Give them all the details. As you can imagine, everyone at the dockyard is pretty spooked. I got a Pazok game planned for them later to help boost morale. Gotta do our part, right? Say, between us, something's up. Something bigger than missing engineers. Ardo ain't talking, and the boss has been shut up in the briefing room all day. I feel like he'd tell us if it was just about the lost engineers. Nah, this is something else. My money's on some kind of unfinished business, like a dark secret he left behind when he skipped out on the Empire. Or not. What would I know, huh? Whatever it is, it's gotta be something he can't fix with a giant battleship. Why don't you head up to the briefing room? The boss might open up to you.
Okay, I've got the information. I was created the A-Wing, the RZ-1 A-Wing Interceptor was in fact created after a General Jan Dodonna created an after-action review and highlighted how a simple trio of staff, TIE starfighters almost foiled the trench run. The TIE Interceptor in Legends was also created, like the Rebels and the Empire created an after-action report and found out that, well, it was created in response. Well, the development had already happened, but acceleration of the development happened, increased after the Battle of Yavin. Yeah, and I think the B-Wing. I remember why the B-Wing was created. We still don't know this droid's name. Or its designator. And you notice how the bottom half of him is blue. It's got blue highlights instead of green ones. Yeah. I'm just gonna double check up on the B-Wing. Okay, history. Oh, it was the B-Wing in Legends Expanded Universe was developed as a counter to the Empire instead of deploying more anti-starfighter ships.
You're right, Lyndon. My contacts verified your suspicions. It's her.
I knew it could only be Teresa Carroll. Her mark is all over these attacks. We know her style.
You do realize there's only one reason she would attack Hosni and Prime in the engineering convoy.
She's searching for Project Starhawk.
Starhawk.
That's why I've already taken steps to stop her. Before she can find the Nadiri dockyards. Before anyone else gets hurt.
Lyndon. What have you done?
Relax, Ardo. All I did was send Teresa a message. One she can't ignore.
I wonder what this mission is.
An old protege of mine, Teresa Carroll, is leading the Empire's search for Project Starhawk. She won't stop until it's destroyed. So I've initiated a plan. I sent a message that we know was intercepted by an Imperial listening post hidden near Essilis.
What was the message?
Bait for Teresa. And now that the Imperial post has served its purpose, we're ready for part two. If we destroy that listening post, Teresa will think we have something to hide and follow that message to the letter. Vanguard, I want you to take Y-Wings with heavy ordnance to that post in Essilis and bomb it to oblivion. A corvette will join you to draw Imperial fire. Gunny will support and resupply our bombers. These are your targets. We've identified the receivers along the hull as weaker areas. Destroy them all. Additionally, Destroy the thermal regulation systems along the exterior trench and any dishes atop the listening post. If you pull this off, we'll rob the Empire of a valuable asset, and then Teressa will fall right into our trap.
I have to say, the commander's plan is quite clever. All this secrecy and subterfuge, it's almost imperial. I know the New Republic strives to be better than the Empire, but you must admit their tactics are effective. Not that we should adopt them, of course, but this is war. Sometimes you have to think like your enemy in order to defeat them. We're lucky the commander is using his tactical brilliance for our side. Let's focus on the mission.
So we haven't figured out what those machines are on the flight suits. I should get this done quickly. I'm actually starting to feel a bit unwell.
Teressa Carroll was my second in command at Fostar Haven. She was my protege. She's gone from a Coruscant street orphan to captaining her own Star Destroyer. The Empire gave her everything, and she'll do anything to defend it. That's why I'm keeping certain details quiet. With Teressa in the game, any leak is a risk. Just trust me a little longer.
I didn't say I didn't trust you.
Zerelda should have your ship almost ready.
Pardon me. Oh man, I think I might... Nope. Won't talk about that now. We're almost 10 minutes into the video and we haven't even left yet. Ah, Kia, what you want?
When Javes talks about Carol, you can feel it, right? He must have cared about her greatly to feel such pain. I don't think it's a coincidence that the Empire sent Teressa after Javes. This feels personal. They must both be hurting. And hurt can so easily turn to hate. Hate that cannot be healed has no place in the galaxy. If fighting it has become the only option, so be it. Are you ready?
Anybody else? Hey?
Y-wings are built to carry bombs and other heavy explosives. It makes them slower, but they pack a punch against large targets and capital ships.
I know there's got to be some, first. This actually seems like a good idea. When shields reach zero, exchange ammo for a brief but nearly invincible barrier. That sounds like a good idea. We won't do it now. Do it later. Still, sounds like a good idea. Where to find. You know what's funny about this? Despite having auto aim, because we're on the story mode difficulty, we pretty much got a type of story of auto aim. Oh, maneuver. I knew there was a... Oh, man, I want to change it. 15 minutes. Damn it, it's still really loud. Just lowered my audio. Feels a free aim.
Temperance, this is Vanguard Squadron. We're closing in on the listening post now.
Excellent. Upon arrival, you should be able to overhear some Imperial chatter. You can thank Ardo and his spy network later.
Let's form up with our Corvette and
life
run
missiles
during the strike.
This listening post in the middle of nowhere. How'd the boss find this place again?
He sent a message, specifically hoping the Empire would intercept it and reveal the outpost. They took the bait.
Talk about a long shot. No way he could have known that would work.
Unless the message he sent seemed so enticing, the Empire had no choice but to intercept.
What could be that enticing?
That's the thing. Jace won't tell us. But it's a seed that will sprout into a trap.
Let's focus on this mission and worry about the details of the trap later.
Shit, don't want to get too close to the dam. Engines. Yeah, engine things about getting damage if you go behind the ship, and the engines also happens to be an X-Wing Alliance detail. Oh, damn, but I'm going.
Dropping on the galaxy.
Well, they do seem hell-bent on finding us. I bet the Empire cannot stand that we're building a new ship out of their old ones.
There's our listening post.
I'll jam Imperial sensors on approach.
I love it. They'll never see us coming.
Let's make them regret eavesdropping on the New Republic, huh?
And just like that, we're hidden from Imperial sensors. Follow me, Five. We'll lead the bombing run.
Grace and I will take care of station defenses and starfighter patrols.
Here we go, Five. Give them everything you got. Good. You're almost there. On my mark, it's bombs away. Now!
What? It's a raid! Alert TIE patrols!
Nicely done. You're a natural, Five. Now to bombard the rest of the receivers.
Get the broadcast system running. We need to call reinforcements.
Uh-oh. Quick, take down those dishes before they can make that distress call.
Squadron, target the dishes on top of the station. Empire can't call reinforcements without it.
We needed that dish.
Oh, I love it.
You've got enemies locked on.
I don't care if we're under attack. Get the broadcast system up so I can call for help.
I felt that from here. Not bad, Five.
Is the broadcast system working? Good. I'm calling in some backup.
Just destroy it. Nice job.
I felt that from here. Not bad, Five.
I missed one. Shit.
Let's get it off our tail then.
Here. Yeah, these things are pretty slow. Man, I love the shields. Going, I'm going, man. Lady. Ma'am.
Alright, five, form up at the edge of the station. It's time to take out the thermal systems.
Should've dodged that.
The thermal systems are located in the trench circling the edge of the station.
I forgot this thing's 3D. Oh shit, we didn't even get all of them.
We have no ties left.
Let him fucking go.
They won't come after the Corvette again. Let's finish off these thermal regulators, huh, Five?
I'll be honest, it's going kind of panicking. So I was looking at it. Wait, who's in the X-Wing? If Gunny's in the U-Wing, and Fist is in the Y-Wing. Jesus! Holy crash, Curtis. I didn't think I was gonna make it. I thought I was gonna flash plant against the thing.
Regroup and prepare for hyperspace jump.
Yeah, I honestly thought I was gonna get squished between the blades. Between the blast tools. Ooh, and I ran out of bombs.
Squadron. Our trap is set. Come on home. It's time for the next step.
Come on, end the mission. End the mission. And it would have been 13 minutes. Oh. How long was the time? 11 minutes. Ah, damn it. You know what? I'm in a good mood and I'm feeling a little bit better. Let's continue. And let's still kick what's around. I mean, I know the they are the New Republic, ain't they? I know the area seems brighter. But I'll be honest, I like the angle, angular visuals of the TIE fighters and the Imperial Star Destroyers. In fact, out of every single Star Wars ship created by the New Republic that I've seen, at least in Legends and in the Expanded Universe, the hell is this? In the Expanded Universe, sorry, I was looking on my screen. And I was actually on the Google page, and it's got a bunch of the Google letters with mask on. And it's a vaccination thing. Yeah. Anyway, what was I talking about? Oh, out of the entire ships, all of them they created, at least capital ships-wise, there's only one of these ships that I would like to have. Only one. It's called the Nebula-class Star Destroyer. You know why I would like to have that ship? It's because it's a dagger. It's got the general arrow shape of the of a Star Destroyer. Man, how many Star Destroyer types are there? But a chest Star Destroyer, which we have no picture of. Let's see what frisking Danny wants.
All I'm saying is, instead of blowing up that listening post, we should have commandeered it. Imagine the kind of fun we could have had messing with the Imperials, or the credits we could make.
As your squad leader, I'm gonna pretend I didn't just hear that.
Come on, Gunny. You telling me the New Republic couldn't use more intel? And you know war ain't cheap.
Actually, that's a good point. I guess once you steal a Star Destroyer, everything Imperial starts to look tempting.
You know, we used to be rebels. Turn into a legit republic, and suddenly we all gotta stay on the straight and narrow.
The commander's lining up a trap for Teresa Carroll. That's not enough of a con for you?
In the old days, I'd trick her for everything but a pair of boots to stand in. But I guess this'll do.
Well, when he's right, he's right. Now, how about we get some actual work done?
Okay. Maybe if the interior lights of Star Destroyers were more warmly, as opposed to being sterile white, would look better. No talking, eh?
We should get started.
I'm waiting on you fellas.
First, congratulations. Because you captured the Star Destroyer Victorum, our Starhawk prototype has been completed ahead of schedule. But the Empire does not know that. They believe it's still under construction. Teresa Carroll will keep hunting Project Starhawk until it's destroyed. And we've been assigned to stop her. So, using that decoy message I sent, we're going to set up an ambush. The false intel stated that you're protecting a shipment of magnite crystals, essential to completing the Starhawk. With this bait, we'll draw Teresa and the Overseer deep into the Xavian Abyss, a highly volatile area of space. Here is where we set our trap. Don't worry about the convoy. It's empty and droid piloted. However, that does mean you'll need to clear any obstructions from its path. Vanguard, I want you to defend that convoy with everything you've got. We need to make this look good. Your destination is this bottleneck. There, the Starhawk will be waiting to disable the Overseer, and hopefully, capture Teresa. Now, it might sound simple, but nothing is simple in the Xavian Abyss. Brace yourselves.
Let's talk to the first person. Damn it, the joke's gone out the window.
This plan could knock Teresa Carroll off our tail. Sooner the better, if you ask me. Lyndon's convinced himself that he's put us in danger. I can't make him focus on the bigger picture while Teresa's still in it. The commander's a smart man, but everyone has someone who can push their buttons. I wonder if we can push hers, too. We'll give Teresa a harmless convoy to follow. Play this out. And see just how far we can lead her. It's all about playing the long game. When the Empire occupied Moncala, I learned how to string Imperials along. If you seem harmless, people underestimate you. I spent a lot of time around Imperials, playing the dumb alien, a bartender, a sweeper, someone safe. Next day, the Rebellion would know everything I'd overheard. It wasn't easy, but I learned to stay patient and wait for opportunities. Remember, the Xavian Abyss is no place for the faint-hearted. And Teresa knows a few tricks of her own. Keep your eyes and ears open, all right?
Moncala.
And Starhawk's crew.
More than ready. I selected the crew personally based on their expertise and experience. They've been training for months.
That's good. I appreciate your support on this, General.
It's a good plan, Lyndon. Just be careful. I know you have a past with the Overseer's captain. Don't let it cloud support your judgment.
One moment, General. Sorry, I can't talk right now. Your squadron is waiting.
You know what's the funny thing? Hera, a character from Star Wars Rebels, and as you can see, Hera Syndulla, she actually originally spoke with a French accent. How do I know that? Because I've seen Star Wars The Bad Batch. That's how I know that. Right, let's go to Frisk.
So, the boss wants to pull the old bait and switch on Teresa. I must be rubbing off on him. Of course, the key to a good con is selling it. And going into the Xavian Abyss, well, either you're too naive to know better, or you think it's worth the risk. Like, say, stopping a Starhawk from being finished. Teresa Carroll's risking the Abyss just for the chance to destroy some magnite crystals. Ain't she in for a surprise? I'm kind of excited to see our Starhawk tackle Teresa's flagship. All those engineers worked their tails off to get it finished. That's one good thing about this new Republic. We're finally punching at the same weight as the Empire. One way or another, this is gonna be a show.
Sorry, I just kept on thinking about the fact that he's a Trandoshan. They're known usually as slavers and hunters. With a big ass beef against the Wookiees. The fact that if a Wookiee came up and was liable to rip his arms off. It's alright though, I think Trandoshans can regenerate their limbs. Like some actual lizards.
I've heard tales of the Xavian Abyss. They say it's swallowed entire fleets without a trace. Sending our brand new Starhawk in there is quite the gamble. Commander Javes must have complete faith in its builders. And in us, of course. We'll be the ones making this ruse work, after all. I took the liberty of studying the Starhawk's blueprints. It's not just another capital ship. It's a defense against Imperial fleets. Every spare inch is packed with lasers and munitions. But what really caught my eye was the tractor beam. If I understood the blueprints, the Starhawk's tractor beam is 10 times more powerful than that of a Star Destroyer. It's incredible. The magnite crystals they use in the Starhawk's tractor beam are quite rare. I think they salvaged a few from the Star Destroyer we captured. My family spent an exorbitant amount of credit sourcing magnite crystals. It's so gratifying to see them go to a good cause. Let's put our new Starhawk through its paces, shall we?
Okay.
You got your choice of fighters for this mission. An X-Wing, Y-Wing, or A-Wing. They've all got pros and cons. Check the schematics and let me know what'll suit you.
Shields for that. Oh wait, do I get to choose the standard laser cannon? Oh no, it's just a burst. I guess it's different for each one. What's the ammo? Oh, I guess we don't have the auto thing. Although the fighter, damn it. I guess it wouldn't really matter with the ion cannons. Man, that would have actually been better on the A-Wing or X-Wing. Sorry, I had a brain fart there. Definitely got a higher max speed and a higher max acceleration, but... Targeting fighters, aren't we? Yes. Oh man, this seems almost tempting. But is the 100 points really worth it? Damn it. Sorry, I'm not actually going to pick that. I just needed to adjust myself. Rods, rockets, proton torpedoes. My new maneuverability. You know what? I think I will change the engine. What about this one?
That'll be fun.
What else? Let me just equip it. What was this one? Ah, yeah. Nope. Excuse me.
You know how to pick them.
Let's try that now, Frank. And if we need to, could always restart the mission.
Once the Starhawk
disables the Overseer. The same as the Victorum, I expect. Board it, lock its systems, and take the crew prisoner.
I don't know, Grace. I can't imagine Teresa Carroll coming along quietly. I hate these clouds. Who knows what's out there?
We know what's out there. A Star Destroyer with a captain who wants us dead.
Came up frisky now and got me all freaked out.
Thanks, Gunny. The convoy's droid autopilot ain't smart enough to steer through these asteroids.
Then let's blast them a path.
Wait, look. A Star Destroyer. Or what's left of one.
I'd say it's been here a long while.
You'd think this would discourage Teresa Carroll.
What's the vinegar?
Someone like her, that wreckage ain't a warning. It's one more insult.
Ships are on radar.
Scouts. Perfect. The boss's plan is working. Give them a show. Make sure they buy it. Come on.
Oh, man.
Enemy is destroyed.
Take that. Fine. Watch the storm. You're in the clear.
Holy shit. Yeah, I'm not falling for that again.
Enemy is destroyed.
I mean, I flew into a goddamn storm. Man, that was freaking rough. Jesus, I flew into the goddamn storm.
There it is. drawn it in.
Nobody panic. This is the plan. Defend the convoy and keep luring the Overseer to the ambush point.
How could you challenge an Imperial Star Destroyer?
Oh shit, they're actually targeting me.
The convoy's under threat. Get those asteroids before the Overseer's too close.
Guess Teresa decided to handle this convoy herself. I got the cold sweat on my neck.
Stay focused.
I am. I'm very focused on the Star Destroyer right behind me.
Trapped with nowhere to go.
Launch fighters!
More Imperial fighters! Check behind!
Gotta take out those bombers!
Enemies wearing me down!
Right here and ready to go!
Easy for you to say you're an invincible NPC.
Thank you.
sector and system we've been looking for.
We've got them right where we want them.
Starhawk works.
They tossed the Overseer around like a loath rat.
Good. Lousy Imperials deserve payback with interest.
Shall we just build a Death Star and get it over with?
Oh, come on, Grace. We're still the good guys. Anyhow, we won, right? Wherever they jumped, no ship's coming back from that.
Let's hope so.
That was an interesting thing. You know what they should do? If a tractor beam can pull in, can it also push out? I don't know, they shot missiles. Huh. Okay. Now what was I saying? Oh, see, if they can also push out as well as pull in, then have the central one pull in while the outer ones push out. Yeah, that way you'll tear your ship apart. Anyway, I'm going to end this video here. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope to see you in the next one. Bye bye now.